Everybody, welcome. Good morning. Wow, what a wonderful, wonderful good morning to see all these. What is that little song you used to sing? And we're all in our places with sunshiny faces. Good morning to you. Y'all went to the same school I did, didn't you? Okay. Anyway, thank you for being here. What a pleasure it is to see you. And do we have any visitors, first-time visitors that would like a welcome packet? I think we have you, sir. Okay. Can we get a packet to this young man over here on the right? Okay. Thank you very much. And welcome to Unity of Winston-Salem. Thank you for being here. As you know, Unity is a praying church. If you have any prayer requests, there's a box out in a prayer box out in the narthex. It has a sheet of paper there. You can fill out a prayer request. It goes to Reverend Forrest for a week. She stays with it and prays with it. Then she sends it on to Silent Unity in Missouri, and they pray over it for 30 days, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The opportunities of the week. Wednesday night, we have our meditative yoga class that begins at 5:30, which is awesome. And then we have our oneness blessing that starts at 7 o'clock, which is getting just so powerful. And meditation, it's just a wonderful place to be, everybody. We all know that. That's what we do, right? We all meditate. Our people who have been in the hospital and in other places recovering from surgeries or this, that, and the other, they're home now and everyone's doing well. There are many of our friends who are going through some difficult times right now. So just hold all our family in prayer and light as we always do. We welcome March. March came in like a lion, didn't it? Yeah. And we're going to hope it goes out like a lamb. So our Easter is going to be just spectacular and beautiful. So start making your plans to be here with us for our Easter service and every service. We sure appreciate it. We're going to start off today with a song that we've sang here for many, many years. And if you just take a deep breath, shake off all that stuff you left at the front door. It's called I Am So Blessed. Okay. This is what we do in meditation. Here we go. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. Again. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. We are so blessed. Yes, we are. We are so blessed. We are so grateful for all that we have. We are so blessed. We are so blessed. We are so grateful. We are so blessed. One more time. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. Namaste.
Thank you, WG. And thank you, Deb. How do you feel? That's a wonderful way to start off every morning, affirming the truth. I am so blessed. We are so blessed. And the past couple of years, and even the past months now, I think many came to this planet to play the parts that they've been playing, to let us know how blessed we've always been. I know there's been big divisions in the past few years. And this wasn't what I was going to talk about today, folks, but here I am. That song just triggers a deep something inside of me. It says, you know, Jesus came, a master among masters. Talking about a course in mastership, that final time that he was here on this planet, and I believe in reincarnation. I hope you don't hold it against me. I had a lot of other teachings, and I respect every teaching, every person on this planet, no matter what you believe, your religious belief. But Jesus, in that last incarnation in the flesh, when he had victory over death, when he had that ability to take all the light that he was, the light of God that was in him, and transmute every cell and every fiber of his being into light, matter being spiritualized, because we are made of light. Love, wisdom, power, all that God is, we are. When he made that final resurrection in the physical form, he had the ability to lower that frequency and come back into the same form if he chose. And we are right on the brink of waking up and discovering we are the sons and daughters of God, just like he taught the whole time. But you know, it's springtime. The whole earth is saying, grow with us. Grow with us. The grass is greener. The buds are popping up. The earth goes in cycles. We go in cycles, lifetime after lifetime. And each time growing just a little bit stronger, learning just a little bit more. We're here at this age that we've talked about, a new age, an age of Aquarius, an age, a time that is thousands and thousands of years long. And we have this opportunity to come into that likeness and that fullness. And thank your friends for coming in and everybody else. I haven't seen this couple in, I don't even know how long, but glad to see it. And I know more and more of you coming in, but I'm going on reincarnation for some kind of crazy reason this morning, I feel like, because I want us to learn, take a look at where are we. And if it's even if it's you just believe in one lifetime, that's fine. But where have you grown since you've heard the message of Jesus? What have you been doing? Did you really hear it? Did you really hear it? He said, you have eyes to see and ears to hear, but you don't hear what Spirit is telling you. Why? Because we have to hear by the Spirit. And each one of us is destined to come to that place. We are. God created us for this reason, so we can go out and seed the universes and be that temple of the living God that we are now. We will know we are God. That's a big stretch. But you know what, Jesus? He came on the scene, and that's what killed him, a part of it. was because he started walking and talking and teaching. And he said, I come to give you what the Father told me to give you. I'm speaking straight from the mouth of God. I have the I am presence, the Christ seed in me. And I speak from that place. And I want you to hear what Spirit is saying to you. People listened and they loved all these things he did. He opened blind eyes. He opened deaf ears. He caused the lame to walk. He knew all the mysteries of the universe, the mysteries of God. And he said, you are going to know this also. And some of us, when we get hold of some of the truth, we think we have it. You know, my little group's got it. Your little group has it too, doesn't it? I bet everybody out there, your little group has it. Wherever you hang out, you've got the truth. And usually nobody else has it because you really got it. They just don't get it, do they? That's what we think. And I think this last couple of years has been one of the most amazing things that could ever happen to us human beings. What's wrong with you, Elizabeth? What's wrong with you? Look what these people have done. These Republicans and these Democrats, they split us wide open. You split us wide open. We split ourselves wide open. You got family and friends you don't even want to talk to. That's first grade stuff, folks. That's kindergarten stuff. We should have learned to get along the moment we heard Jesus speaking to us. When he started talking about love, the greatest commandment is love. Oh, I love them if they love me. I love them if they'll help me. I love them if this, that, and the other. Oh, but if they don't treat me right, I spite them, don't you? Don't want anything to do with them, do you? We are like kids. And we think we have it. I realize today we're so far from it. The majority of this world, including myself, I'm not to that place that I can lay down the body right now and resurrect it with the light that's in me. And the only way I'm going to begin to evolve with the light, the Christ coming forward and being more and more of who I am, is if I walk my talk. If I walk my talk. And I fail every day. But I want to get back up. I don't want to lay back down. I don't want to keep gossiping. I don't want to keep putting somebody down. I don't want to keep saying you're wrong and I'm right. It doesn't feel right to me anymore. It doesn't feel right to me anymore. Maybe that's why I fell right in the middle of this person that I met years ago, and Sri Sri Ravi Krishna. He's going to be coming to North Carolina, folks. We're going to be doing some breathing exercise on April the 20th. Sri Sri will not be here with us that night, but a lady that's in India with him right now, that's a friend of mine, she'll be here to talk about the breath. Breath is life. Breath is light. Now, I'm not doing this to push that, but what I'm seeing is a bigger picture. He believes the world is a family. It doesn't matter what you believe, how you walk, how you talk, what color you are, what's your religion, what kind of walk you walk. It doesn't matter. Some of you will freak out if you're really these straight, narrow path people. It doesn't matter if you're gay, you're straight, you're bisexual, you're whatever it is. Guess what? God loves us all. God loves us all. And we need to accept each other right where we are. I'm not going to get upset with a first grader that doesn't understand what a 10th grader does or a college professor does. We grow each lifetime. We learn each lifetime until we come into that incarnation that we recognize we are the manifestation of a son, of a daughter of God. But we could be at any stage in that growth when we recognize it. Are you with me? Are you with me? So how in the world can I think I have arrived if I snub you because you don't believe the way I believe? You don't like the same people I like. And still think that this place called heaven is where I'm going to get into. I'm going to walk those streets of gold. You might not. And I'm going to have all these stars in my crown. You know, baby, I'm right. You're wrong. But if I despise you for some reason, ain't going to be no stars in my crown. That's the way you believe. And there's not going to, the streets of gold. We take things so literally, but we don't take it by the Spirit. When I was in maybe my early 20s, I began to question the streets of cold, matches on the hilltop, all those kind of things. And I thought, well, I'd just like to have a house that the roof didn't leak, you know, and it was warm in the winter. It'd be really nice to have some hot running water. I just had the tin tub. All those things went through my mind. But then I realized that's the material things. And we think of a place called heaven in material ways. What are those symbols of streets of gold? The streets of gold is that pure walk. That pure walk. The symbology is about purity, the pearls. Oh, that pearl of great price is finding that Christ within me. And I will do anything to arrive to that place of accomplishing that. We're here. We're right here at the edge of all these things. If we can hear what Spirit is saying to us. But first, folks, we got to turn loose of all this pettiness things in the world. How many people came in to be in wars right now? We're wondering, why is the wars going on? Why are the children dying? They came from you. They came for you and me. Just as Jesus came here and walked through what he walked through. I don't know where this is coming from, but I'm going with it, folks. They are here to reach out and get your compassion. And think, how can we keep murdering children? How can we bomb children? How can we do that to anybody? You know? But we have to come to that place of recognizing what we as humans are doing. Well, I'm not doing that. Keep sending your hate out to Putin. Keep sending your hate out to Washington. Keep sending your hate out to your grandmother or your cousin or your neighbor. Keep sending that hate. What is hate? It's war. It's division. It's death. It's destructive. We are going to come to the place eventually where we recognize we are the creators of this world. We're the creators of our own life. And it comes from every thought, every feeling, every emotion, every negative thing we think, and every beautiful thing we think. Whew. Jesus said, I come to show you the way. I can't drag you there. I can't do these things, but I'll tell you what. I'm going to give you the truth. I'm going to tell you where I'm from. And he said that I came from the higher place. I know what I'm talking about. I came from heaven. Not a place that you can pinpoint, but a dimension from whence we all came from. And we came in and we became a living soul. Where am I going with this? We became a living soul. Adam became a living soul. And he was of the earth, earthly. You are a living soul. You are of the earth, earthly. That's the first Adam. The second Adam is what? It's life. It's spirit. It's the man. That's from the higher dimension, from heaven. It is that when spirit becomes alive and can be seen. Jesus was here showing us what the Father was. He went on the Mount of Transfiguration with Peter, James, and John. Well, us uni folks, we like metaphysical stuff. We may think we're better than you. It's just some people got together and started praying and seeking their heart, and things start coming. This can happen. This happens to anybody. It'll happen to you now. You're in that stream, life stream right now, where information is willing to come to you. If you open your heart and you want to receive, you can receive it. When you turn loose of the bitterness, the hate, the division, when you come to that frequency, it's law of attraction. Y'all like that because it's a lot of money, you think. I want to attract the things of this world. I want to attract the things of spirit. I want to attract the things at higher dimensions. Because the more you start looking at that, the more you find peace within yourself, the more these things out here doesn't matter. It used to matter to me, especially on Easter and Christmas. We had, again, more seats than we do now. And they were all filled up. Remember, Barbara, we used to put chairs in the back and up the front. Yeah, that mattered. Whew, made me feel good. Now it doesn't matter if two or three are here. It really doesn't matter anymore. I want those people here that when somebody sings in spirit, you hear it with your heart. You hear it with your soul. It moves you. I want each of us to be a vessel of that living spirit, that we're coming here to come in spirit and in truth. Because you know what happens? I can feel it right here. I can feel the spirit in you, the divine in you. I can feel it. And in that feeling, why do you think I can't shut my mouth right now? It's because it begins to expand. It's expanding from you. It's expanding in this room and beyond this room and beyond Winston-Salem and beyond North Carolina. It will spread. The love and the peace, the more we get together, the more we get together. So this is what these past years have been. You can hate Biden or Trump or any of the leaders in the United States that you want to. It's not going to do you any good. Because you know what? They came in. People said, some people used to think that I'm this or I'm that or I'm other. The way I see it, I was trying to tell people, if you can hear me this time, if you can hear what I'm saying, if you can hear what the I am a me is telling you. I'm not for this one or that one. I see the truth that they came in to play their part. This is a huge movie that we're moving through the past years. And each and every one of us have a part to play. They play the part that will irritate the heck out of you. They play the part where your anger, your resentment, every fiber of your being can begin to lift up people that you can't stand, and you put them in little groups, and you just put them in those groups and you send out that hate. What's that hate doing? Is polluting the world. You think oil and different things are polluting the world in the car. Da, da, da. That's the pollution of the world. We are the pollution of the world. Our thinking, our stinking thinking is what's going on. So they're there to draw it out of you. You know why? So I can see it in me. So I can see it in somebody else. Where you can see it in yourself. Because over the years, I've thought, I'm not prejudiced about anything. No, I'm not prejudiced about anything. Until one day, a really beautiful gay girl decided she was attracted to my son. Because she thought they would have beautiful children. Now, when I found this out, I didn't think I was prejudiced, but something triggered in me. I'll confess. Here I am. I'm telling in public, but I feel like you know everything about me anyway. But there was that there. I couldn't comprehend what she wanted to be with him for. Why this? And I said, you can't be gay. You can't be. Why are you going with my son? You know, why? And she got pregnant. And that, I said, how are you going to, this doesn't compute to me. I was raised in a Baptist box. I was saturated in it. But somehow I was different or thought different from a child. I didn't see people different. But when it got here, somehow it got into a deep place that was in me. So I had to look at that. And then she said, but I am going to have another child by him. No, you're not going to do that. Surely you will not do that. You won't do that. Now, don't, I can't process this. That's really what was going on. But she did. Two beautiful grandsons. They're both in their 20s now. And I truly love her. And I love her for bringing them into my life. There's no bitterness. There's no hate. I learned to love her. But we each have our own paths. But I'm just saying, we have to look deep inside of us, because my prejudice towards somebody, I would not walk those streets of gold. Not streets of gold, literally. But I can't walk that high vibration of spirit. I can't be who I thought I wanted to be as long as I had that in me. So many of us have bitterness still. And you have hate. And I was taught all you had to do to come down here to the altar and bow down and say, God, forgive me. Hey, take it away. Take it away. Take it away. Take it away. Oh, please take it away. You've probably done that before. And then whatever it was you gave up, give it a week or two and it sprouts back up. But we're in a different vibration right now. If you truly want to seek the highest and best of who you are, and to be able to express that, there's only one judge of what's going on in you and me. That's you. That's you. We cover it up, and we have for so many eons of time of thinking it's all right. I can keep this one little thing in me. But when you take your last breath, honey, you may be shocked to find out you're not where you thought you were going to be. Because you can't take your carnal baggage into what we call heaven, or that higher consciousness, that divine consciousness. It just won't go. So guess what we do? Back in first grade again. Back in again. Over and over and over. This earth plane is a pathway to mastership. It's a pathway to mastership. Jesus got his mastership the moment he rose from that grave and then came back into that physical form, from physical, material, to total spiritual, and then back again. I've been weaving back and forth just wherever the energy's taking me. But I do remember I said he went to the Mount of Transfiguration, Jesus said. In his human form, he took Peter, James, and John with him. And here goes the metaphysical stuff. Every word, every person, every place, things that are in the Bible. We have this book that people have meditated and especially the Fillmores helped get it together, of studying all kinds of things all over the world, what names and what places mean. And so it's, you can read that book, Metaphysical Bible Dictionary. So in that, Peter, James, and John, they're his disciples. Remember? Remember those names, Peter, James, and John? He had 12 disciples. And those disciples have qualities, or they were given qualities. Okay, the first one, John. Most of us know what John represents. What do you think of when you think of John? Love, yeah. He's the beloved one. He's that easygoing one. And they all have they all have a power. Right now, I started to say them all, but it was like, wait, go somewhere else. Just finish three you got there, Elizabeth. But each have a quality they represent. So John represents love. I'm just floating right now, folks. The other two are Peter and James. James represents wisdom. Peter represents faith. So he's taking faith, wisdom, understanding is what it means. Peter, it also has in that energy field I'm seeing, it's like a ball with words all over it. But it represents the intuition that is beginning to develop more and more. That intuition is a part of that spiritual essence of who you are that will bring forth knowledge and wisdom as you walk that path. You walk that path. So that begins to evolve in us. And the faith takes us to knowing all things are possible. And then that love. So if you have those three essences in you that are beginning to evolve and are awakening, that love is that part of you that loves without any condition. That love. These are part of the divine consciousness that are within us that we don't awaken all at one time. And you don't usually awaken them all at one time in one lifetime. Each of you are developing a part of the Christ consciousness each lifetime, and you may vacillate back and forth. We do. I hit on it because I was listening to what people used to say about me and stuff, but I can feel, and it's only been in the recent years that I really got that it was true, that for me this lifetime it is about love. And I know some of you may think I'm a phony because I can't shut up about I care for you, I really love you. If I didn't, I wouldn't say it. But my great test with that love was going through a divorce. We learn through things. A person that was abusive to me mentally, emotionally, physically for 22 years. And to my children too. And I somehow couldn't get out of it. Just couldn't make myself do it. You know, it's going to be worse if I do this to my kids. It's going to be worse. How am I going to make it? All these kind of crazy things. And I'd pray and pray, Lord, change him, change him, change him, change him, change him. Please, Lord, change him. And it was like there was no change. And I thought, well, I can't leave. I don't know what to do. And I heard you have a choice. But the choice was for me to grow or not grow this lifetime. That's all it was. A choice to grow or not to grow. And in that choice, I thought, I can't do that. It was like, you make a choice. Because a cat's a cat, a bird's a bird. A dog's a dog, cat's a cat. And I got it. I understood Spirit was saying, everything has its own personality. And then my husband's name at that time was spoken, and he is who he is. No amount of my praying could change that man. He would have to make the choice to change. And it may be that he would change if I left. And I would change if I left. So I did. A couple of years later, I met Tony, or less than that, it was about a year, but I've known him for 35 years now. This week, we'll be married 33 years. Life totally changed, totally changed. I'm just using this as an example. That's all I'm using it for. Because you have a story too. There's been something in you that you made changes. But all of this has been about us growing. The whole thing is about us growing. And I had bitterness towards him. Over the years, I've had all my teeth just about in the front and sides and different places kept. And the dentist said, oh my gosh, honey. He said, you must have been in a terrible wreck. He says it because it's when something hits you, it destroys the nerves. I didn't make a comment. Yeah, it was like being in a wreck some days. But all that faded in the background. All that faded. Money, houses, boats, cars, skiing, all those things just left, just like that. And I don't regret it one bit in the world. But I didn't have anybody to lean on. Yet, God supported me through every step I took. And I've had a magnificent, magnificent 20-some years of meeting what I wanted to meet when I was a little girl. I didn't want to meet the Beatles, the rock stars. I wanted to meet spiritual people. I wanted to meet Oral Roberts, Billy Graham, and I met them. I wanted to meet the most spiritual people on the planet, and I met them in person. I've traveled with God preparing the way, and I'm not saying this bragging, but go to India and the bill be met. You think you're going to put it on your card and somebody else picks up the tab. Go to Brazil and the monies just flow. Do these things to meet different people. And what I'm saying is when you're on your path, God makes the way. And God supplies the source. This is how powerful God is. This is how powerful God is in you, whether you know it or not. I never knew I was tracking that good to me. I never knew that my dreams were being fulfilled. I even wound up in Russia when the walls fell down. How did that happen? Tony couldn't believe it. I couldn't, but I did believe it. I knew out of all of the Methodist people at Winston-Salem, there were going to be 8 people selected to go to Russia. Once the wall came down. I wasn't a minister then. Well, yeah, I was. This little thing that I got through the mail. But we were studying. It was a study course I was taking. But that didn't pay attention to that. We were going to a Methodist church. But I wasn't a member. And Tony said, honey, you have to be a member of church probably for many, many years. I said, I'm joining church next week. Alternative, you know, a motive, but I really liked the church and we stayed there for many, many years, taught Sunday school and stuff, Tony and I did together. But that was a pathway to do what me and one other girl, lady, are the only two that was supported by the church that we went to. And I'm talking about even ministers went and their church didn't give them the money to go. But I went just being little old me. I had money that I gave away when I left. I wasn't going to keep anything that was given to me. Blessed, blessed experiences. And here again, I'm telling you because all that you're looking to do in this lifetime, if your heart is right and you're doing it for the right reason, guess what? It's going to happen. It's going to happen. You are a child of God. You are a creator. We're just now waking up to our creative potential. Laws of attraction, any of that, that's true. We create because we're creator beings. So what I want to pull you back into is look at what you're creating. You're not only creating for yourself, but you're creating for the community you're in, you're creating for the bigger community, you're creating for the world at large, because we're adding our negative or positive thoughts into the pool. So every day when I get up, because of what happened this morning, that song you played, that song you sang, I am so blessed. I am so blessed. If I have to go back to pinto beans and rice or salad greens or apples or whatever, if the world starts falling apart because of our negative thinking, our negative actions, and our speaking against everybody, I want to pray for Putin, folks. How about you? I'm going to pray for everybody in the world. I'm going to send light and love, because when you're in darkness, you need it the most. But who am I to judge? We're going to find out some people on this planet that you think are darker than dark may be working undercover. That just came in from somewhere. And they're actually working for good when you think you're working for bad. And you're going to think things that people that you just worship, the ground they walk on, are serving the dark forces. Because there is dark and light here. It's that time. It's that time. And as things begin to move into a higher dimension, there will be things. There's going to be duality. We live in a world of duality. But as we're living in it, Jesus told us. He told us how to deal with all this. Anybody remember? Be in the world, but not of the world. If we would look at his teachings, they're so, so simple that we just don't get them. But they've already been with us for over 2,000 years. It's time to come back to basics, folks. And you're not the judge of somebody else. I'm not the judge of somebody else. Whether I like what they do personally or not, I'm not their judge. But we will be our own judge. Things have changed in me just from a couple of weeks ago when I mentioned the prayer I've learned not to say unless I wanted something to happen. Is, Lord, heal what needs to be healed. Reveal what needs to be revealed in me, that my life can be transformed. That my life can be transformed. When you start using that, you may feel like everything comes tumbling down. But then you have to find out, how do I react to this situation? How do I react to what somebody just said about me? How do I react to what I just found out somebody said or thought about me? My gosh, you know, it could hit you in the gut. But I'm finding there doesn't have to be a reaction. Just a recepting, receiving. Oh, that's what they think. Okay. Be it good, bad, or indifferent. They have the right to think whatever they want to think. They can make their choices. Do you know that? So why are we bitter towards anybody? Unity. Come together in unity and love. Jesus taught unity. The disciples taught unity. Forget not the gathering of yourself together. Because the more we get together, we discover we are that body of the Christ consciousness. We are cells in the body of God, each having our particular thing to do. You know, my stomach does one thing, my bladder does another, my heart. You might not see everything that's going on, but there's so much going on inside the body. That's us, folks. We're the body of that huge consciousness. And are we a cancer cell in it? Where'd that come from? Are we destroying or belittling or weakening the body of Christ? How many churches are all over this? A lot have closed, but how many are all over this world that profess to be that body, spiritual body? But how many cancerous cells, I'm using that as an example, are in there? Something to think about. Something to think about. Because when something's going on in the body, what happens? The rest of the body wants to rally, to heal it, to disperse of those things. If we are hearing what Spirit has to say this day, I hope we can each take it into our heart. There's no fingers being pointed at anybody in this. This is just the word coming forth. It's coming to me too. I have to listen. Am I here to strengthen the body of Christ, or am I here trying to tear it down? There's no reason why every building that is a spiritual building. Okay, I got that too. They said every building is spiritual. Everybody, everything spiritual. But why aren't they full? You know, why aren't we working together to heal the sick, to cast out the negative thought forms from within us and within others? Why aren't we helping each other? Why aren't we feeding the hungry? Why aren't we educating the children? Why aren't we families like we used to be? Nobody did it to us. We did it to ourselves. We all did it to ourselves. So just a little food to take home today and to think on these things, and I certainly will. But I'm so glad you've been with me today. I really am honored. I mean, I am feeling so much gratitude to be here on this planet at this time. You are spiritual warriors. You're not battling flesh and blood, but principalities and power that's in high places. The darkness that has been ruling this dimension, this earth, for eons and eons of time, hiding in the darkness. But you came. You're here. And guess what? You are the light of the world, as Jesus said. You've been hiding your light. All you have to do is walk in love, talk in love, be that love, be that breath of God, recognizing that every breath you take is a gift from the divine. It's light itself. Everything came from light. Everything is a vibration of light. Scientists, chemists, whatever, they're discovering this. Just different vibrations of light. So we breathe in that light and that love from the universe. And it never asks you or tells you how to use that breath of life. How to use it. It's my gift. A gift is not giving it and saying, but you got to use it in a certain way. It's your gift. It's your gift. So no judgment. But you make the choice. As for me and my house, I want to be a light, not a self-righteous snob trying to convince to you I'm something, because I'm just a self, whatever God created me to be. I just am as I am, as all of us are. But I want to serve. How about you? How about you? I'm going to read a daily word, I think. And after the daily word, realize I don't have shoes on. Shoes, we would stand on truth, but shoes symbolize restriction. Do you know that? You restrict yourself. And maybe high heels are to say, I'm just a little bit higher than you are, folks. Who knows what it means? But we're not judging today. But that just came to my natural mind. So let's just take a moment just to relax. And I'd like to share the daily word with you today. Didn't get into anything I meant to get into, but I hope whatever I was talking about, I pray it was beneficial. I may just listen to it and find out too this week. If it turns out on Zoom, that's another thing. If somebody would like to help with live streaming, Someone came in, a blessed person, and he's willing to help us with it, but we don't have the pocketbook stuff, you know. The dollars and cents aren't there, but if you want to help upgrade our system, if anybody out there wants to just give a love offering or gift, you may do so. But also the inflow, I don't talk about money. I don't like to talk about money, but the inflow for the church because of COVID and stuff, it's not a fraction of what it has been over the years. Salaries have lessened. Things have changed to keep the doors open. So if you, whoever's watching, if you really want to keep the doors open, make sure I want to keep the doors open as long as I can just keep the doors open, whether we got lights or heat or anything. But so far we've done well to do that as far as we have. So you are welcome to give if you like. But if you don't feel like it, you're not blessed being blessed by it, you know, send it someplace else you're being blessed. The board won't like that, will they? But, but okay, let's just close our eyes and I'll share the daily word because I'm lowering back down too much here. Just take a deep breath and relax. Let us give thanks for this day and for this opportunity of being together, to come together in unity and love, and to recognize it's not for us to judge anything except our own self, our own actions, our own ways. And then allow our spirit to sit on the heart's throne rather than the ego, and to rule those thoughts and feelings and emotions. And in this time of spring, we're beginning to plant, and the plants and the seeds, may we plant seeds of positive thoughts, which bring forth the harvest of joy. Every gardener knows that blooms grow best in good soil. Even before planting, it's good practice to pull the weeds and prepare the soil, giving the seeds the optimal condition in which to grow. Today, this is for all of us, I believe. If you feel that, I hope so. Today, I tend the garden of my own consciousness. I pull the weeds of worrisome and unforgiving thoughts by denying they have power over me. For I create a fertile environment for new positive thoughts now. Positive thoughts to grow through regular prayer and daily meditation. When I touch that place of infinite stillness, infinite peace, I affirm my wholeness, prosperity, happiness, and security for my life. Like bright, beautiful flowers, these positive thoughts bloom and grow in my consciousness. In Philippians 4:8, we read, "So whatsoever is true, whatsoever is honorable, whatsoever is just, whatsoever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, think about these things." Thank you, our loving Creator, for reminding us to remember the teachings of the Master, or the Masters that have been on this planet. And remember, for us to remember from whence we came, it's time to remember. 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 Thank you, God, for directing us in that knowingness that no matter what's going on, you are with us and all is well. Thank you, God. So if your life changes, my life changes. We are the ones that's changing it, folks. So I pray we all work together for a glorious change in life. Deb?
talking about those blockages. Y'all going to get some here. I hope I don't sneeze. I have to go to the bathroom. And I don't know this song all that well. So, please bear with me. Oh, and the trip to Russia. There was a book. And that group that Elizabeth went with. Now, this is just awesome. They pledged to that little village one cow a year. Imagine that. To that village, they pledged one cow a year. That was hard for me to digest. What a blessing to that village. To have that. Linda has been to places where that would have been, what a gift, what a gift. So that story, that really resonated with me. It's how awesome we can be when we try. I hope I hit the right button. I woke up this morning and I saw a world full of trouble. Now I thought, how do we ever get so far down? How we ever gonna turn around? So I turned my eyes to heaven. I thought, God, why don't you do something? Well, I couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty and children sold into slavery. The thought disgusted me, so shook my fist in heaven. I said, God, why don't you do something? He said, I do. Yeah, I created you. That's the truth. If not us, then who? If not me and you right now, yo, it's time for us to do something. If not now, then when will we see an end? All this pain, it's not enough to do nothing. It's time for us to do something. I'm so tired of talking about how we are God's hands and feet. It's easier than to breathe like angels of apathy. Tell ourselves it's alright. Somebody else is gonna do something. Tired of life with no desire. I don't want a flame, I want a fire. I want to need one. I'm gonna do something. If not us, then who? If not me and you right now, yo, it's time for us to do something. It's time for us to do something. We are the salt of the earth. We are a city on the hill. We're never gonna change the world by standing still. No, we can't stand still. No, we can't stand still. No, we can't stand still. Oh, 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 oh. not us, then who? If not me and you right now. Yes, it's time for us to do something. If not now, then when will we see an end of this pain? Oh, it's time for us to do something. It's time for us to do something. It's time for us to do something. Ooh. It's time for us to do something. Yeah. Amen.
I tell you, there for a little bit, I was wishing I was in the Holiness Church, because everybody would be up, you know, let's do something. You know, we think that the government's going to do something about it. We think a president's going to do something about it. We think some other country's going to do something about it. Change is coming. We, the people, are going to do something. You watch. The people are going to rise up. The people are going to bring the peace. The people are going to bring the harmony. The people that are together, that love one another and are not against each other because of who you they think you are or who they are, or you believe one way and the others believe another. That day is over for us. We've either got to drop it and or we're not, they're not moving on. But there are some in this country and in this world, and I believe you are too. Those that can work together, I want them to start coming together. I want us to start coming together and know we're over that petty, childish stuff in kindergarten or high school, I guess, and start loving each other for who we are. So thank you, each and every one of you that are here today. And I know you'll take your light out and you'll do something. You'll do something wonderful. You'll share your peace, your joy. You'll love without condition. That is something big. So thank you all for being with us. If you would like to give a love offering, if this has blessed you in any way, if the ushers would please come forth as WG leads us in song. But we will bless this first. Find love through me. Blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And I am grateful.
Thank you, WG. Thank you.
Next Sunday, Tony and I are going to be away celebrating our anniversary, his birthday, and our grandson's birthday. And so Troy Hurst is going to be here with you next week, but we'll be back the next Sunday. So everyone come in and have a wonderful time. Let's bless this together. Thanks for this visible evidence of the bounty of God. We send it forth with love and joy to do its perfect work. Thank you, God. If you'd like to, we'll come together, and if you'd like to hold hands or not, that's fine. And we'll close in the peace song. And welcome those that came. They didn't set their clock up last week, and you're still on the other time. Thank y'all for coming in today. We do have CDs if you'd like to get a CD recording of the service. So let's see. Okay. All right, WG.